And I know you all want to know more about that. Well, humans trying to live in space are like fish trying to live out of water. Space is a hostile environment for human beings. And what's unique about space is that there is an apparent lack of gravity called zero gravity or microgravity. And of course, when there is no gravity, everything floats. There is no up and there is no down. But that's not all there is to space. Now, the first thing that happens when you get into space is that all the fluids in your body move up in your extremities. You get all puffy in the face and even your nose gets stuffy. And your blood starts moving differently too. You lose calcium in your bones while at the same time your spine extends 1.5 to 2 inches in an 8 to a 48-hour period. It's quite a growing spurt. But everything does return to normal when you get back on Earth. But while you're up there, the word normal has a new definition. Also, the first day or two in space, I should not still feel too well. You seem to come down with something called space motion sickness, which makes some things come up. But that usually goes away after a day or two. Well, now that everyone knows a few of the hazards of space, let's see if we have any potential astronauts out here who would like to start their astronaut training, help to demonstrate this module. Do we have any? Do you want to be an astronaut? Well, come on up here. I saw your hand. Come right over here. And what is your name?
Chris.
Chris? Where are you from?
South Korea.
All right. Well, let's wish Chris good luck as he starts his astronaut training. Give him a big round of applause, everyone. All right, Chris, let's go ahead and move up into your new home away from home. Be sure to wave goodbye to all your friends out there, Chris. You may be gone a long time. All right, now, Chris, the dimensions of your module are governed by the size of the cargo bay of the shuttle, which has to bring it up from Earth. Now, we've cut this demonstration module away right here so that everyone out there can see in. But actually, there are equipment units here and here as well. Remember, all four surfaces are right side up. And since you float, you don't need a floor to walk on. Now, Chris, you will notice that the entire length of the module are divided up into equal sections like this one, called an ORU for Orbital Replacement Unit. Each of these units are interchangeable, and since everything is weightless, it's relatively easy to move these units around on the station or even out of the station for a trip back to Earth. So let's come on down here, Chris, and we're going to take a closer look at one of these units. Let me have it right over here. There you go. All right, now, Chris, now this is a typical crew storage rack. Each astronaut will have one. It sort of acts like their closet in space. And Chris, this one is yours. I want you to reach up, grab that handle right over there. Let's pull this forward a little bit so we can get a better look at it. There we go. Come over here, Chris, and you'll see the drawer configuration here on the side. Now, you'll notice there are extra drawers in the back. This fills out the curvature of the module because you can't afford to waste a single cubic centimeter, so we use it all. Let's come over here, Chris. We're going to open this drawer and take a look inside. Chris, tell everyone what you see inside here.
I see clothes.
I got a bunch of clothes. And what's on top of all those clothes? How's your net? Why don't you unhook that side? Let's hold this net up and show everyone. Unhook that side for me. Hold it. There you go. All right, now, Chris, you don't want to forget to place this net on top of your clothes, because if you should open your drawer in zero gravity without this net holding the net, you know what would happen, Chris? Your underwear would go floating off down your module, and you'd have to go get it. So let's hook that net back on top here. You hook your side. There you go. Keep everything in place. All right, push this out of the way. All right, Chris, why don't you come over here? You hop up into this unit right here for me. There we go. Now you got to slip your arms into the slot there at the side. One on that side. There we go. Now each astronaut will get a full 8 hours of rest. And these sleep restraint units will hold the astronauts in place so they don't go floating around bumping into switches or other astronauts. How does that feel sleeping strapped to a wall? Not too good, yeah. Okay, watch everyone. Let me see if you feel any different when I get you strapped in up here, okay? No, I'm just kidding now. But in space, one astronaut could be sleeping here, or one here, one right where I'm standing. It would all feel the same. Each of our astronauts have their own areas that they're able to curtain off for privacy. So let's come on out of here. Watch your step. There, as you come out, here we go. Now, each astronaut will need to exercise to maintain muscle tone and prevent bone loss. Now, this unit will help counteract the negative effects of weightlessness. So, Chris, go ahead and hop on this dual cycler dumper. We're just going to work our upper body. So, just put your feet right down there. Grab these handles. We're going to work our arms and start pedaling your arms. There we go. Yeah. Now, this video on the back wall shows the other exercise equipment available on this station. All this equipment is geared toward cardiovascular conditioning and muscle tone. Remember, your bones lose calcium in space, so an effective exercise regimen will help counter this condition. In fact, everything that we learn about the human body in zero gravity has long-term benefits for us back here on Earth. Chris, you did a real good job exercising. Why don't you come on out there? And we're going to take a look now behind curtain number one. Let's pull this out a little bit, get a better look at it. Now, Chris, do you know what this is?
I don't know.
No, okay, I'm going to give you a little hint here. Yeah, that's right. This is our space bathroom, part of the waste management facility. Now, normally, Chris, you know, a privacy panel would be closed over this area. But, Chris, this is a public demonstration. No, I'm kidding, Chris. You come alive. All right. Now, after the astronauts close over a privacy panel, they float over and slip their feet in these little restraint units to hold themselves down because gravity's not there to do it for them. And then they take these cushion brace units. Now, these are on springs, and they place them over their thighs to keep them on target. Then they press a button here in the back, and that starts the negative airflow or suction in the stainless steel canister below them. Now, in the compartment up front, there's a funnel connected to a tube. This is for collecting the urine. Now, the solid waste is processed and disposed of. However, the urine and all wastewater on board the station is recycled and purified back into drinking water. Remember, air and water are your two most valuable commodities in space. So come over here, Chris, and let's talk about how we conserve all that water on the station. Now, to wash their hands, NASA uses antibacterial wipes to do that. And to bathe, they just use a larger wipe, like a Huggies wipe. Now, to wash their hair, NASA has developed a no-rinse shampoo. You just put this in their hair and lather it up, and all they have to do is towel it dry. Now, Chris, to brush teeth, you can't run water in the sink like you do here on Earth, so NASA has developed a special ingestible toothpaste. You put your toothpaste on your toothbrush and brush your teeth, keeping your mouth closed at all times. Then you can either swallow that toothpaste or you can take a sip of water and spit that water and toothpaste into a towel. So, Chris, with that taste in our mouth, let's take a look behind curtain two. All right, now, Chris, this is your space shower. Now, there isn't a shower on board the International Space Station, but we did have one on Skylab back in the 70s. So let me show you how that would work. Inside there is a nozzle, and this is for spraying the water. And there is a second nozzle. Now, this is a vacuum for drying off. Remember, water can't flow down a drain. It just sort of hangs around until that vacuum picks it up. But the astronauts on board Skylab found that they really didn't like using the shower. It took too much time and effort to use, so that's why we just use those large wipes today. And you can take a look at the Skylab shower in the Skylab trainer in Starship Gallery. Come on down here, Chris, because these next two units, this is your crew healthcare facility. These two units act like your first aid station in space. Here you can take care of such things as cuts and abrasions and your space sickness, but it's also able to do other diagnostic testing such as blood and urine analysis. Each of our astronauts are trained in emergency medical technique, so the necessary skill is always on board. So now, Chris, has all this technical talk and training made you hungry? Yeah, come on down here, Chris, to your galley area. Here you and your fellow astronauts with me to prepare your food, talk about what's happened during the day, basically to relax. So there could be a number of astronauts floating around this area, some right side up, some upside down, talking and preparing food. Chris, I want you to hold that packet for me, right? Okay, now, preparing food in space has its own set of challenges. Now, each of the food packets has a little Velcro patch on the back. That's for attaching it to the walls as they gather their food together to keep them in place. We also have magnets available to hold silverware in place so it doesn't go floating off down the module. Now, food comes prepared several different ways. Go ahead and show everyone what you're holding. Turn that around so they can see. Pull that up real high. Now, this is chicken teriyaki, and it is ready to eat, hermetically sealed in this pouch. So all the astronauts have to do is just heat that pouch up, cut it open, and eat that chicken right out of the pouch. Now, we also have some canned goods on board as well. But in order to save on space as well as weight, most of the American food is prepared and dehydrated and sealed in these pouches. All the astronauts have to do is place these pouches into the food rehydration unit, put water in it. Let's see, this jambalaya needs 100 milliliters of hot water and 15 minutes in the microwave. It doesn't look too appetizing there, all dehydrated. Not really, but once you put this water in there, rehydrate it, and heat it up in the microwave, oh, it's just like Mom used to make back in Louisiana. Good stuff. All right, now, Chris, do you like to snack?
Yes.
Like M&M's?
Yes.
Yeah, well, our astronauts love snacking on M&M's. They can also snack on nuts and pretzels, a goldfish, anything that doesn't create a lot of crumbs, because the crumbs can float around in the station and get into the equipment. So that's why you won't find any bread on board the station. So now, what are you going to do with your beef patty if you want to have a hamburger without hamburger buns? Or you can just wrap it up into a tortilla, have a tortilla burger instead. And there's lots of tortillas on the station. Some are being eaten and some are being played with like frisbees. Well, Chris, you've come to the end of your astronaut training, but you have passed with flying colors. Give Chris here a big round of applause. You did a great job. I want to thank everyone for joining me here. Let me face you. Have any questions? I'll be right down here. Thank you and enjoy the rest of your day here. Thank you.